Hello guys, my name is Akshay Momaya and today in this video we will talk about all of the important and relevant features of Samsung Exynos 2100 or you can say Samsung Exynos 2100 in under 5 minutes. If you guys are new to this channel, a sub would be great. Talking about number 5, we have security. In 2021, smartphone security is a major concern because we are improving the technology and we are increasing the vulnerability. So Samsung has done a very interesting thing. It has added a Strongbox Keymaster, which is a hardware dedicated security feature inside its chipset. So along with the Android security, Android software security and this hardware security, we will get much more better user safety, or you can say overall security in our smartphones. So well done Samsung. I'm looking for almost every smartphone to integrate this feature. It would be great. Now coming to number 4. At number 4 we have network. As you guys have known, 2009 was the year Samsung has introduced the commercial 5G. So Samsung has been adding the modems, improving it, and finally Samsung is at that kind of stage where it has integrated the modem, that is 5G modem, inside its chipset. What it means for us as a user is it has improved the speed to 7.3 Gbps. So yes, finally Samsung has done it. Great job again. What it means to us is that we will get much lesser network lags and gamers. You will enjoy this mod. Coming to number 3, camera. And here is where the things get crazy. Samsung's ISP, or you can say image processing block, can handle 200 megapixel camera. I mean, 200 megapixel is a lot. And if that was not enough, Samsung has decided to support 6 cameras at a time. Okay, now things get even much crazier. It can support, or you can use 4 cameras at a time. I mean, who at his right mind would use 4 cameras at a time? But 4 cameras at a time. Wow, Samsung, hats off. Again, this is not the craziest part. The craziest part is Samsung Exynos 2100 can support 8K at 30 fps, and it can decode 8K at 60 fps. So again, great job. Not revolutionary, but great job. Step in the right direction. Coming to number 2, graphics, or you can say GPU. So Samsung Exynos 2100 has used ARM Mali G78, which is a 14 core processor, or you can say 14 core GPU inside its chipset. So what it does, or what it means for you and me as a user, is that we will get a 40% GPU hike. Now understand, this 40% is on the previous generation. If you guys have used a Samsung 4 before, you guys know how great their display is and how great their GPU performance is. And we are getting a 40% hike over it. I mean, this is a true value for us as a user and consumer. So again, great job Samsung. Now let's go to number 1 and the most awaited and most awarded position, that is CPU. Finally, Samsung Exynos 2100 has accepted 5 nanometer technology. It has a CPU at 8 core, which is a 8 core CPU at 2.9 gigahertz. 8 core CPU, 2.9 gigahertz, and 5 nanometer technology. In terms of consumer, it is a 30% improvement of efficiency, or you can say CPU power, and 20% improvement on power consumption. So we will get a better battery life, we will get a efficient CPU, we will get a much more faster and crisper flagship experience. So again, great job Samsung. With that being said, let's conclude the video. So we are getting a better CPU, we are getting a better GPU, we are getting better security, we are getting better network, and we are getting better camera. So in all, I would say this is a win-win situation for us. So great job Samsung, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends, and let me know in the comments which was your favorite feature from 2021's Exynos. I'm excited to see what you guys think. So, with that being said, I will see you guys in the next one. Until that, goodbye.
It's time to stop. It's time to stop, okay? No more.